Want to speak real Polish from your first lesson? Sign up for your free lifetime account at PolishPod101.com.
So the first word is, and I promise you, this is the most difficult word you will ever learn in Polish, as for the pronunciation, is książcz. I will just say it again. Książcz, which means beetle. Yeah, so we use it a lot for tongue twisters. Like, for example, a very famous one is książcz brzmi w Szczecinie, w Szczebrzeszynie, which means beetle sounds in the reeds in a town called Szczebrzeszyn, which makes it even more difficult to say. Książcz brzmi w Szczecinie, w Szczebrzeszynie. Oh, yeah, that was correct. Lubić. Lubić means just to like something, so whenever you're asking somebody, what do you like, or you want to say, I like this, you would use this verb. Of course, change it, depending on the person. For example, you can say, lubisz lody? Do you like ice cream? Which basically means hello. And for example, if you meet your friend, you can say, cześć, jak się masz? Hi, hello. Hi, how are you? Cześć, jak się masz? Just be prepared to hear the very, very long answer for the part, how are you? Mówić. So when you translate it to English, it just means to say. You can get angry at somebody. Nie mów takich rzeczy. Which means don't say such things. Kochać. That one is very good for Valentine's Day. So kochać means to love. And for example, you know, you love your sweetheart, but sometimes you don't really understand this person. So you can say like, kocham cię, ale czasem cię nie rozumiem. Which means I love you, but sometimes I don't understand you. Słyszeć. Słyszeć means to hear in English. And for example, you can say, słyszałam, że tu mają dobre pierogi. I've heard they have good dumplings here. So, if you're a girl, you would say słyszałam, I've heard. If you're a guy, you would say słyszałem. So, słyszałam, słyszałem. It will change a little bit depending on the gender. You can basically take this sentence and put something different at the end and use it as a kind of set phrase. Słyszałam, że. Niespodzianka. Niespodzianka means a surprise, and this noun is actually very, very funny because it comes from two different words. So nie, which is basically a negation, means no, and spodzianka, it's from spodziewać się, which means to expect something. So it's like not expecting something or something that is not expected, which basically gives you a surprise. For example, imagine that you are in this long-distance relationship with your girlfriend and then she doesn't say anything and she just comes to you with no notice and you open the door and you are very surprised to see her there and then you say, a to mi zrobiłaś niespodziankę. Oh, you sure surprised me. Wiedzieć. Wiedzieć is translated to English as to know, and it is a little bit tricky verb because people often confuse it with another verb, znać. And both actually are translated as to know into English. So, for example, you can say nic nie wiem. I do not know anything. Nic nie wiem. I do not know anything. So the next word is spać, which means to sleep. And for example, when you meet your friend in the morning and you want to ask, like, did you sleep well? In Polish, we would say wyspałaś się, if that's a girl, or wyspałeś się, if that's a guy. I know that this wyspałaś się doesn't really sound like spać because we attach W-Y in front of it, but it actually is the same verb. Again, for a girl, you can say wyspałaś się, did you sleep well? Or for a guy, wyspałeś się. Przyjść, to come. For example, you are at the party and you want to know who is coming. So you ask your friend, who is the organizer, kto przyjdzie na przyjęcie? Who is coming to the party? Okay, so the next word is szczęśliwy, which basically means happy. Well, let's go back to this Valentine's Day and when you are with your sweetheart and you want to say how happy you are with him, you can say jestem z tobą bardzo szczęśliwa, which means I'm very happy with you. And this is something that a girl would say. If you're a guy, you just have to change this last part. Szczęśliwa, szczęśliwy, patrzeć, which means to look. So, for example, you can say when you saw something weird and you want to show it to your friend or something interesting, popatrz tam, look there, zdrowy. Zdrowy means healthy. And there is this very common Polish saying that you can use. It's w zdrowym ciele zdrowy duch, which means in a healthy body, healthy mind. Dać. Dać means to give. So when you go out and you meet this nice guy or cute girl and you want to ask them for their email address, you'd ask them using dać. Dasz mi swój email? Will you give me your email address? Czenia później. And it means see you later. When you are going back home, you want to say bye to your friends, coworkers, classmates or anybody else, you can say no to do zobaczenia później. Well, see you later. Znaleźć. Znaleźć means to find. Imagine your friend brought you a nice dress and which you are going to wear at a party, but you don't really like it. It doesn't suit you well and you want to ask her to find you something better. So you can say, może uda się znaleźć coś lepszego? Which means, maybe we can find something better. Przepraszam means I'm sorry. Zapytać. Zapytać means to ask. Sometimes when you want to ask for something which is very difficult to ask for and, you know, just to be nice, you want to say like, can I ask you something? In Polish you can say, czy mogę cię o coś zapytać? Or you can even ask, excuse me, can I ask you something? Przepraszam. Czy mogę cię o coś zapytać? Gdzie jest toaleta? Which means, where is the toilet? So, gdzie means actually where. Jest means be or to be. And toaleta is toilet. So, gdzie jest toaleta means where is the toilet. So, if you are in a shopping mall or in a restaurant and you want to ask, excuse me, where is the toilet? You will say, przepraszam, gdzie jest toaleta? Wejść. Wejść means to enter or to come in. Well, when your friend visits you and you want to just say, please come in, please, or just, you know, you can say, wejdź proszę, which means literally, come in, please. Ile to kosztuje means, how much is this? When you go to a shop, you will say, przepraszam, ile to kosztuje? So, excuse me, how much is this? Przepraszam, ile to kosztuje? Próbować. Próbować means to try. Let's say your friend is visiting and you made this wonderful food, amazing dishes, and you want him or her to try it. You can invite them saying spróbuj to, which means try it. Pomocy. This means help, and I hope you will not have to use this one anytime soon. But if you're ever in danger, if you ever in a like very dangerous situation, which I hope you will not be in Poland, you can use this one, saying pomocy, zadzwonić. So zadzwonić means to call. And let's say somebody calls you and you cannot really talk right now, so you want to say, okay, I will call you back later. You just say zadzwonię potem, I will call later. I can't speak Polish very well. Nie potrafię means I can't. Mówić means to speak. And then po polsku means in Polish. So, nie potrafię mówić po polsku? It literally means I can't speak Polish very well. Or I can't speak in Polish very well, if you wanted a very literal translation. When you start learning the language and you are still not so good and you meet like people and you want to tell them that your Polish is not so good or it's not super good yet, you can use this phrase. nie potrafię dobrze mówić po polsku.
Want to speed up your language learning? Take your very first lesson with us. You'll start speaking in minutes and master real conversations. Sign up for your free lifetime account. Just click the link in the description.